Hi all, welcome in the AWS Solution Architect Certification Associate Exam Dump. So in this series, I am including one more question related to that NAT instance, which is very useful when we want to communicate with the private subnet. So let's jump on the questions. We'll follow the same strategy. We will try to figure out that where is the hint on the question, and as well as we will mark the wrong answers so that we will come to know that what is the correct answer. So let's jump on the question. So today's question is, an internet facing multi-tier web application must be highly available. So this question is related to the HA. An ELB classic load balancer is deployed in front of web tier. Amazon EC2 instance at the web application tier and deployed evenly across two availability zones. The database is deployed using RDS multi-aged. A NAT instance is launched for Amazon EC2 instance and database resource to the access the internet. These instances are not assigned with public IP address. Which component poses a potential single point of failure in this architecture? So let me mark the hint. So the first hint is like that it is HA. So this is the high availability. And the next hint is like that a NAT instance is launched for Amazon EC2 instance and database resource to access the internet. So you can see like that this question related to availability zone, and we are talking about the high availability. However, they have mentioned like that there is only one NAT instance is configured. So when we are talking about the HA, then make sure that you are having the multiple instances are running, and it would be difficult if there is only one instance is configured, and if it is fails, then there is a problem of the availability. So question itself is saying like that the next instance is only one here, and which can cause the which can reduce the availability if it is being failed, then there will not be any failover. And another one is like that not assigned with public IP address. So just I'm marking it. So basically here you can say that NAT instance is being used to communicate with the private subnet. So I will jump on, and the last hint point is single point of failure. So already we have figured out that there is only one instance, so which will cause the single point of failure. Let's jump on the answer. So Amazon EC2 instance, no, because already they have spoken about that two availability zone. A NAT instance, already it is mentioned in the question, so this is the right answer. ELB, so I will jump here, and here you can say like that an ELB classic load balancer is deployed in front of the web tier. So you can think like that, okay, the ELB can be cause of the issue because there is a one ELB classic load balancer, but the thing is like that the ELB not having ELB itself is means like AWS itself is saying that ELB is highly available. So it is not required for you to having a multiple instances when ELB should be enough, and it is just in front of the web tier. So as well as there is also mentioned like Amazon EC2 instance at the web application tier are deployed evenly across the two availability zones. So this first line itself is trying to say that the same configuration is available on the both availability zone. So it is not only the one, but one ELB classic load balancer and one web tier and one database is configured into the one availability zone, and the same kind of design is available into the another availability zone. Now, so I am marking as it's wrong because same configuration has been done into the another availability zone. Amazon RDS, no, because it is already mentioned the same configuration is available onto the another availability zone. So let me go to that what exactly is the NAT gateway. So here in this design you can see that there is a web server, and it is public, it is in the public subnet, and if the web servers want to communicate with the database, so there is a NAT gateway. So yeah, so NAT gateway is being called from the web server, and web service is the only one point where you can call the database. So here you can say that there is no any possibilities that internet gateway directly called to the database server, because router itself will get a call from the web server only. The configuration is saying that we are configuring the web server here, that is the target is local, and there is a internet gateway is configured here. In the private subnet where our database is there, we have to configure NAT gateway so that NAT gateway can communicate with the database server. So this is the main route table where we have made an entry for the NAT gateway ID. And I was just trying to say that why one single NAT gateway if we are having into the one availability zone, sorry, in the multiple availability zone, if you are using only one NAT, then there will be a single point of failure. But here we are having the two NAT gateway. One is this one and another one is this one. So here you can see that even the one NAT gateway is failing, then it will jump to the another NAT gateway and there will not be any single point of failure. So this is the correct high availability design if you are using the NAT gateway, and it should be the multiple for each gateway. This is the more details about the AWS high availability zone NAT instances, where to use, how to use, and where in the main route table how we can configure details about the NAT gateway. So this is all from my side. Thanks a lot, guys.